Doctors of Reddit, what is the most mind-blowing recovery you've ever witnessed? Not a doctor but a nurse who worked in long-term care. I had a patient who was apparently actively dying. She had stopped eating for 3-4 days and was on comfort measures only. This meant she was receiving morphine every hour and the rest of her medications were discontinued. And she was only being fed and given water as tolerated. Out of nowhere one day she just sat up and said I'm hungry, and like that she was back to normal. She lived for around another year or so after that. That's interesting. In hospice. I saw patients typically get that burst of energy before they transitioned. I like the perspective that it was the universe's way of giving the person a chance to say their goodbyes to their loved ones. Resident doctor here. I've seen this happen before in palliative care. It's usually due to decreased cerebral edema as the patient starts to dehydrate. They suddenly get better and then die over the next short future. Paramedic fireman here. Had a guy, 65-ish years old, who dropped dead while on a treadmill. Let's show asystole. Which means dead as hell. Zero electrical activity in his heart. One round of CPR with one round of ALS meds. Goes into a shockable rhythm. Defibrillate, shock, one time. Guy gets a normal heart rhythm back with a pulse. Loaded him up. Had a 5-minute transport. By the time we got to the hospital, this man was making jokes with us and would have walked in if we let him. This is not how cardiac arrests go. You usually die. And if you live, your quality of life after is usually greatly reduced if not negligible. This was absolutely incredible. I had something similar happen to one of my patients. Guy came in with chest pain and arrested right in the waiting room. CPR was started immediately, was shocked twice and came back. Had no idea anything happened. Sent us a basket of fruit every year on the anniversary with a card saying thank you for saving my life. I don't work there anymore but I'm sure he still sends it. If he's still around. Have seen a lot of remarkable recoveries back to baseline from people unconscious and intubated in ICU. Especially in young people who have high physiological reserve to bounce back from catastrophic events, for example. Thyroid storm. Aneurysms. Ketoacidosis. I'd say the most surprising recovery was in a drug and alcohol patient. Man in his 20s with a very difficult upbringing. Dropped out of high school at 15 and was just hooked on meth and alcohol since. Very expensive habit, so he'd commit crimes to fund the drugs. Get out of prison and back to us for rehabilitation. Commit another crime. A horrible cycle. He wasn't motivated to recover because he didn't have much of a life to return to. Serious health problems from drug use. Nobody would hire him due to his criminal record. Parents in prison. Also seemed mildly intellectually impaired. Possibly from chronic drug use. He only had his girlfriend. Then his girlfriend died of a drug overdose. I thought he'd follow after because he was hanging on just for her. But he did a total 180. Booked himself into detox. Attended all his appointments. Got his high school equivalency. Stayed clean 4 years and got hired as a security guard. On discharge. He was with a new partner and they had a baby on the way. During his last appointment he dropped into the dollar store and had a bag with a stuffed elephant and pink blanket inside. Sorry, I am not a doctor. But my brother had been given hours to live 3 times during his battle with cancer. I flew to see him and say goodbye all 3 times and another 20 odd times to give moral support over the 2 years he fought. One night in the hospital the doctors told us to say goodbye as he had only hours to live. We all fell asleep holding his hand and at 6 a.m. I opened my eyes and listened to see if I could hear breathing. It was quite dark and all I heard was my brother's voice saying holy shti, I am still here. He lived for another year. Not a doctor. But this is my mom's story from a few years before I was born. She was driving home during a really bad snowstorm. She lost control of her car. Swerved into the opposite lane and got T-boned by a pickup truck. The truck hit her car so hard. The driver's portion of the car was pretty much all that was left somewhat intact. My mom sat there lifeless for 30 minutes before anyone even called for help. Rescue had to use the jaws of life to get her out of the wreck and rushed her to the hospital. While in the hospital, doctors told her family that they've done all they can. But all other patients in situations like hers either died or were comatose for the rest of their life. And she probably wasn't going to make it. Soon after that, her blood started to coagulate. And her road to recovery began. She had to learn how to do everything again. Talk. Walk. Hold her head up. Feed herself. Clean herself. Dress herself. Etc. To make a long story short. After a year, I think, she went to the house of the head surgeon who operated on her and introduced herself. The doctor had to excuse himself for a while so he could gather his emotions because he just couldn't believe that my mom made the recovery she did. She doesn't even look like anything happened to her. But since her accident, she has lived with a quarter of a lung missing, one kidney missing, double vision, and partial loss of feeling on her right side. Other than that, she looks and acts perfectly healthy. 4 years after her accident, she gave birth to me. I think she's a walking miracle and she's the strongest person I know. Edit, you guys are too kind. I could cry lol. Edit 2, I'm so happy to see that so many of you were touched by my mother's story. You guys are great. Resident here. This one is more of mind-blowing remission than an acute recovery. Had one patient in one of my internal medicine rotations in medical school who was admitted for hip surgery, who was one of the nicest, sweetest people I've ever met. Her surgery was pretty routine and there were no complications. In her past medical history, she was diagnosed with stage IV endometrial cancer that had spread to her brain. Apparently she had undergone chemo, radiation, primary tumor resection, and surgery to remove the brain met. She remained cancer-free since that period. The fact that she had undergone that whole ordeal and appeared to be mostly healthy and was in remission from her cancer really blew my mind. Not a doctor, but a relative. My grandma ended up in bed for about a year when she was in her mid-70s. She had been declining for a fair while, and just kept getting more and more medication to take care of her different illnesses and discomfort. I went up there 3 months before this and I was sure I wouldn't see her again. She was almost comatose, just lying in her bed, barely being responsive. At one point, my 7-year-old second cousin randomly overhears my mom telling my aunt that grandma started on yet another type of medication, far into double digits. 7-year-old start crying because apparently she thinks that medicine is making grandma more sick, and every time she gets more pills, she gets more tired. My mom and aunt comfort this poor kid, telling her that it is not the medicine that is making her sick and whatever you tell a 7-year-old to calm them down. My mom is a nurse, always back then. She is retired now. She worked with her best friend at a smaller private hospital in Denmark, and a week later in the lunchroom she is telling her friend the story about my cousin. The in-house anesthetist picks up on the convo. Asks about what type of medication grandma is on. Mom starts mentioning the ones she remembers, which really gets this guy's attention. Basically, my mom names a chain reaction, like medicine A has lack of energy as a side effect and another side effect, which is then treated with B that causes lack of energy and another side effect that is then treated with C, etc. So basically, if grandma didn't get A, she wouldn't need B. Capital C. Dorian, that is just the 5 medicines that my mom remembered of the top of her head. Mom gets a list of all the medicines together for her colleague. Apparently him and his doctor Mrs. went over them as an after dinner activity, and the next morning he had a 3-page letter written up that my mom could give grandma's doctor arguing why 25 out of 28 medications were at best unnecessary if not harmful. Mom got the next day off. Drove 450 kilometers to see grandma's doctor. Showed up without an appointment. Pulled a Karen. Got to see him. Showed him the letter and half an hour later left with a new medicine schedule to step grandma out of 25 different medicines and half the dose of the 3 remainings. 2 days later my grandma got out of bed for no apparent reason for the first time in 6 months. 2 months later she was walking the dog and baking again. 15 years later grandma is still alive. She is missing a leg now, and 4 years ago she moved into a retirement home with my grandpa. I haven't seen her for 3 years. But she is doing good. She ended up getting compensated by the stated. Can't remember the figures, but it was the maximum amount, mind you. Not that high in Denmark. Resident here. When I was a medical student on a cardiology rotation, we had a very nice 40 years old lady that was being treated for a heart attack, kinda young. But okay. This type of heart attack, deemed an NSTEMI, is the type where she did not have to be urgently rushed to the cath lab. So she had hers the morning after she was admitted. Seemingly fine before going down. While in the cath lab, she spontaneously went into cardiac arrest. They got her back after 2 shocks. Multiple rounds of CPR. And a round of EP. Usually, if someone is coding for a while, it doesn't look good for them. But she came back and was intubated. So it's more of a watch and wait deal after. Well, overnight, she self-extubated herself. When I rounded on her in the morning, she was awake and said she felt fine. Her only complaint was that she felt like she got burned on her chest. And that was irritating her a bit. Oh yay. That was the 200 joules of electricity going through you a few hours ago. She then went on asking when she was going to be discharged, because she needed to go home and take care of her 2 dogs. The fact that she went into cardiac arrest in-house and in a shockable rhythm definitely helped her chances of a good outcome. But it's still one of my cooler stories. BC, contrary to what people see in the TV shows, people don't just wake up eager to take on the day after cardiac arrest. Cardiac care nurse here. Got called to the ER to assist with the cardiac arrest of this patient in his 50s. He had a delay of 10 minutes, no oxygen to his brains for 10 minutes. The EMT already tried reviving him for 45 minutes on a flat line. After 15 minutes the doctor said, "Last check before we declare this patient deceased," and when we did, he actually had a pulse and a decent rhythm on the monitor. Mind you, we use an automatic CPR machine so we don't have to do manual compression, so we had to turn off the machine to check. He got wheeled to the ICU. Ended up on the coronary care 2 days later, pretty confused I might add, and a week later he walked out of the hospital when the doctors discharged him without any brain damage or visual physical damage. Edit, they give him a pacemaker before his discharge. I'm a patient, not a doctor. I was diagnosed at 22 with lupus and got acutely sick very quickly, which is a little out of the ordinary for the disease. Long story short, it's almost healed me a few times, but I'm lucky enough to call myself healthy for the time being. I've had a lot of doctors and met a lot of rounding med students since I'm a fun teaching case. Anyway, a couple years ago I was out with my daughter at a park and I ran into the doctor who originally diagnosed me forever ago. I was acutely ill at the time I met him and my prognosis was pretty grim. I hadn't seen him in over 10 years. He hesitantly walked up to me and asked my name and then yelled, "Oh my god, you have a daughter." Honestly, I have never seen a grown man so excited in my life. He was almost giddy. He wanted to know everything about how I had been doing and just kept smiling when I said I was married with kids and had been feeling good for the past few years. It was such a chance run-in, but I'm so glad he got to see me doing well. Since he had seen me at my absolute worst. Makes me smile just thinking about it. As a resident, I admitted a patient for a COPD exacerbation. Pretty routine. What wasn't was her history. She had been discharged from the hospital 4 years before with hospice. She had biopsy-proven small cell lung cancer that had metastasized to other organs. Essentially zero survival, and she had gone home to receive medicine to make her comfortable. She hadn't taken any cancer treatment. 4 years later when I admitted her, there was no trace of cancer. The only suggestion from the pulmonologist was her crack coke habit must have been lethal to the cancer. Or her body just found a way to fight it off. Basically we don't know how, and her odds of doing it should be about zero. Typical not a doctor. And not mine either. My mom was driving someplace on the highway. And it was winter. She started seeing semi-trucks on the side of the road. Having slid off from the ice. By the time she decided enough was enough, it was too late. She hit black ice and slid into the opposite lane. Straight into a semi going 60 miles per hour. Rolled down the side of the semi. And somehow ended up with both the cab's landing leg and her van's engine in her lap. The entire back half of her vehicle was sheared off behind the passenger and driver's seats. Ended up in the median. The first person there took me into their vehicle to keep warm. I was a year old. Saved by the blanket draped over my seat, and she called for the medics. Because of the horrific scene, paramedics assumed she was DOA. So they did code 1 to the scene. The medic strolls up to the driver's side. And my mom says boo. She tells me the practically guy sheet his pants. Then hurried to set her free. After cutting through the wreckage, they got her to the local hospital. Then life flighted her to the bigger one. She had a broken femur. Lots of cuts from the glass. Broken left arm. 2 or 3 ribs. Hip. Knee. And ankle. Plus internal bleeding. That seemed to disappear once they arrived at the hospital. Turns out she received a B. Which she still suffers from 19 years later. The most significant part of the recovery, however, was raising a special needs child and a son by herself. My father left her because of the accident, and no one else would help her. She couldn't do physical therapy or even get treatment for her TB because of it.